people you know as a friend that does not fit your own description, that does not speak the same language, that does not eat the same food, that does not look like you, that does not share the same background. It's very little. Am I right? Wow, you have a non-Muslim friend? You have a white friend? I'm an Arab. You have a non-Arab friend? لِتَعَارَفُ. This is why he created you and me in different ways. And he is able of creating us any way he wants. Subhanah. Then the hidden, which comes to the best. The best among you, you all know. This is how you translate it, actually. Or the most honorable one. It depends how you want to translate. أَتْقَاكُمْ. The most honorable, the best among you, not women or men. Nothing to do with gender. Taqwa. Why am I wasting my time about I am a woman or I am a man? Did you get my point? It's not going to make any difference in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Zero. If I am in front of him, subhanahu, he's not going to look at me, I am Haifa or I am Muhammad. He's going to look at me as what? His creation, his servant, regardless he or she. So why am I wasting my time in you? This is the trap you all have to get out of. You probably did not expect me to say this, but we need to get out of this trap. Don't fall into the gender. Look at the bigger picture. Right? وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ. What did he say? إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَ. Did he define who's the Khalifa? Did he say a man? Did he say a woman? Did he say an Arab? Did he say a non-Arab? Why do we fall in this trap? Why? It's me. It's you. This is the first thing you all have to start rethinking. Change the way you think and look individually. Individually, are you falling into this trap? The answer is, I want to hear it. Yes, yes. Whether I am in the trap of being the victim or I am in the trap of being the one who's going to carry the justice against the victim. Both of them, I am missing the point. Because what it should be my point, I want all of you to think with me. Why I am in this world? The question was raised in more than one speaker. Why I'm here? To have fun? To prove I am the best? To prove we are equal? Is that why he created me? I need to hear the answer. Why did he create me? And what does worship mean? To know him. To know him. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And you go and read the commentary. Al-ibadah huna is not worship. Because if you translate worship, you absolutely have narrowed this verse. Oh, I need to pray. Oh, I need to fast. Oh, I need to wear my hijab. You missed it. 80% of this verse, you missed it. Know Allah. I had this discussion recently with someone. A lot of people have dreams, which the dreams are beautiful. And they said, we need to bring Medina back in our masajid. It's a beautiful dream. And they looked at me and they sensed I have something different. And I'm going to ask you the question I asked. When did Medina start? After how many years? Roughly. Right? Why didn't Medina start first? Isn't Allah capable? And what was the difference between Medina and Mecca? Not the cities. لمسلم أمة. As you heard, Al-Ansar, the helper, the lover, everybody loves each other. We don't need Medina. This is what I said. We don't need Medina. What do we need? Why? Because we don't have him inside us. This is what Al-Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam did in all his time in Mecca. Even salah didn't come first. It's يا أيها الناس اعبدوا الله اعبدوا ربكم. Worship your Lord. Know who is your Lord. And this is our problem. And I'm not going to say it's a woman problem. I'm going to be very honest. It's a humanity problem. We don't know who's Allah. Right? If I ask you who's Allah, you're going to tell me he's the one who created me. But does you really believe he's the one who created you? Do you really believe in this? And I say, okay, give me another thing. And you're going to give me all the 99 names, if even more. And you say, he's a Razzaq. And I said, really? She looked at me, I was like, what did I say? I said, is he really a Razzaq? Is he really a Razzaq? I want to hear the answer. Really? Then why do you call somebody else when you need something? It's sad. It's painful. You just said he's a Razzaq. Why do you call someone else? You just said he's Al-Qawi. You give me any of the names you know. And then immediately he tests me and he tests you. Immediately. And I, without me knowing, showing him, and he knows. But to show me how hypocrite I am in my tongue. He's a Shafi. He's the one who cured. And when I get sick, what do I do? Do I call him first? Do I turn to him, Ya Rabbi, please cure me? Ya Allah, make this tablet that I'm putting in my mouth works? No. Who is the best physician? And you start texting and on the groups. This is what we are missing. We women, and again, I'm speaking because I'm speaking to women. What we are missing these days to be the best. And I'm going to give you some examples of the best. Some of them you don't even know the name, and I don't know the name. The best is the woman who her focus in life is not her children, is not her husband, is not her career, is not her beauty, it's not her house. It's only one answer. Al-Wahid, the one. How many of you, and don't show me hands, this is between you and Allah, and He knows. How many of you can say it confidently, as if she is in front of Allah, and says, Ya Rabbi, I lived for you. I did everything for you. I got married for you. I had children for you. I studied, worked hard to make my career for you. I wanted to be educated for you. Memorized the Quran for you. Islamic studies, started Islamic institutions, you name it, for you. How many can claim this now and in front of Allah will say it? The answer is, if I want to be very honest with everybody, if I say this, am I right? Am I honest with myself? That's what's missing, ladies, my beautiful sisters, young and old. Don't blame the young. I stopped a long time ago blaming the young. You know why? Because what they are seeing in me, what are they seeing? And I'm not defending them, but it's again reality. So here you are in Pleasanton, let's say in St. Louis, let's say in Southern California, and you are this pious woman, real pious woman, everybody knows, mashallah. And then they accused you of the most painful, degrading accusation a woman can have. And what is that as a Muslim woman? Exactly. Oh, she has an affair. What will happen to you? Answer me. What will happen to you? Everybody is talking. It's the talk of the town. Everyone. But no one say this to you. But you can see it. You can feel it. You know, you come in and they stop talking. And then your husband comes to you. And he says to you in your face, in front of your father and mother, tell me, if you did it, ask Allah to forgive you. Feel what I'm saying. And if you didn't do it, say it. What will you answer? I want to hear it. What will you say? Honestly. Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakil. If you know this in the Arabic language, when you say Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakil, meaning you have given up and I'm not going to even answer, and may Allah punish you. Because Sayyidina Ibrahim said that when he was thrown in the fire. What else you will do? Anxiety, panic attack, you're going to cry. Am I right? Angry, how dare, what do you think of me, look at yourself, and on and on and on and on. Right? How many will turn and says, you allowed it to happen, Ya Allah. What are you teaching me? What do you want me to say? What should I do? Whose story was this? What did she answer? That's what I need to hear. You all knew the answer. Alhamdulillah. That's the best. To me, this is the best. In all the stories of Sayyidina Aisha, everything you know about Sayyidina Aisha, this story, tell me what a strong woman should be, what a woman of Allah should be, and what a woman of opinion should be. What did she say? And who said that to her was Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. I will be dead. Every time I read this, I just can't imagine. I'm a woman, you are a woman. You know how painful is this? Let alone you're innocent, let alone it's coming from your husband, let alone your husband is the best of the creation. Alayhi salatu wasalam. What did she say? You need to memorize that statement. You want to be strong? You have your opinion? You want to be a woman of Allah? You want to be the best? What did she say? The meaning. لَقَدْ وَقَعَ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. She said this to her father, mother, and husband. الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام. سيدنا أبو بكر أم رومان. She said, it's already in your heart. And if I said, I am innocent, and Allah knows I am innocent, see what came out of the mouth. You will not believe me. And if I say I did it, and I didn't do it, you will believe me. And I'm not going to say a word other than what the father of Yaqub, she couldn't even remember his name, said. And she turned her back to Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam and to Sayyidina Abu Bakr, her father, and to Umm Ruman, and said, فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ وَاللَّهُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَى مَا تَصِفُونَ. What a woman is this? Beautiful, patient, and Allah will help me about what you are saying about me. And she turned her back. This is she. Go and read this in the Quran. In every commentary of Hadithul Ifk, Ayatul Ifk, you will hear this story. It's narrated by her. And then she said, Wallahi, I never thought, look at this. I never thought I am she worthy in the sight of Allah that He will send the Quran to be recited till the end of the time to tell me I am innocent. And then immediately that page of Surah An-Nur, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ جَاءُوا بِالْإِفْكِ عُصْبَةٌ مِّنْكُمْ لَا تَحْسَبُوهُ شَرًّا لَكُمْ بَلْ هُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ لكل امرئ منهم ما اكتسب من الإثم والذي تولى كبره منهم له عذاب عظيم. And she said, I could see الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام Quran is being revealed because he changed. And you know what happens to him when Quran was revealed. And then he starts smiling. And he looked at her and he said, Nazar, the meaning of your innocence came from Allah, from the heavens. Everybody is happy, right? Wait. The impact is not done yet. The best is to the last. So her father and her mother, Qumi, get up. Go to Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. She said, no. I am only gonna thank the one who sent my innocence. It's Allah. Where are you from that example? Woman 2022, live in the United States, live in California, educated, you have everything. Where are you from this? What is the difference between me, you, all of us, and Sayyida Aisha? Don't tell me she's the wife of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. She was tested because she was the wife of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. What is the difference? I need to hear it and I want you to think. How can I be like the finger of Sayyida Aisha? Finger. Nail. One hair. How? You know what's missing? It's not because they don't let women go to the masjid. And I have my own opinion about that. And I'm one of the people who says, لا تمنعوا إماء الله مساجد الله. Don't prevent the servant of Allah, the she servant of Allah, from the houses of Allah. But that's not the issue. The issue is not the masjid, believe me. The masjid is not because of lack of education, believe me. You know what's the issue? It's me. It's my nafs. It's me. Everything is way more. I say this to me. I'm talking to me, not to you. Everything in this life is more important than him. I think of everyone else first and then him. I only think of him when I need him. تعرف إلى الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة. Know Allah at time of adversity, He will know you at time of. I'm sorry, learn about Allah and turn to Allah at time of prosperity, He will know you at time of adversity. That's a Sayyida Aisha. Do you know about her ibadah? About her act of worship? How long a man came? Of course she was a faqiha, she was knowledgeable, you all know that. So a man came to ask her a question, duha time, during the day. And then she found her praying. Duha, two rukat. He was waiting. And waiting. And waiting, because she was still praying. Another man came to him and says, oh, you're waiting for her to finish? Go and do whatever you need to do and come back. She may be finished. How long is your salah? If you pray 5 times a day, how long is your dua? How long is your reading the Quran? And how long you spend time on the WhatsApp, social media, or in the kitchen. It's painful. It's so painful, young and old. And I'm not speaking to the young. I'm speaking to everybody. The best is that woman who I heard it from a young girl 20 years ago. We were in an Islamic conference. We were in line asking the Sheikh. She looked at him and says, "Ya Sheikh, I heard this. I have decided to go to Jannah." Subhanallah, I was like, what? You know, what do we normally decide? I am going to go to medical school. I am going to move. I'm going to buy a house. I am going to have another baby. I am going to, you know, this is how we decide. This is major decisions. And I looked and I was like, what made her put this goal? I haven't seen her. I actually saw only her back. I don't even know how she looks like. But I can tell she's young. Young. Maybe 17, 18, 19. How many of us, your goal is Jannah? I should have asked you before I said this. من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فأولئك يدخلون الجنة يرزقون فيها بغير حساب. Whosoever does a good deed, man and a woman, why do you worry about it? Why do you worry about it and you waste your energy and think about it? He said it. Read your Quran. ذكرين أو أنثى. Man and a woman. But you need to do the first part. من عمل صالحا وهو مؤمن. And you're a believer, not a believer. I believe in Allah. And the first test Allah gives you, good or bad, by the way, good or bad. You are praying for your son to get married. You're praying for your daughter to get married. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send exactly your dua you did on the night of Al-Qadr, Allah send it. And the first thing you do is what? You throw this wedding with every disobedience of him. Every disobedience of him. And you want to be the best. ألا إن سلعة الله غالية ألا إن سلعة الله جنة. What Allah has is very expensive. It's very expensive. It's very hard. It's Jannah. That's the best. That's the best. You want to be the best? That's the best. You want to talk about equality? I don't like this word. It annoys me, honestly, always. I was like, why do I need to care about this? He said it. إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات. Right? والخاشعين والخاشعات والصادقين والصادقات والصابرين والصابرات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات. What will happen? أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما. Every description, and I'm going to go through it because that's the best. This is the best. Muslim, true Muslim, man and woman. Believer, man and woman. Surrender to Allah, man and woman. Patient, man and woman. Truthful, man and woman. Sa'imi, fasting, Ramadan is coming, man and woman. Charity, man and woman. Guard your private part, and not necessarily only private part. Everything else gets to that direction. Guard it, men and women. Yes, he does need to lower her gaze, but you need to lower your gaze first. I, a long time ago, I get very irritated from blaming others. This is not Islam. It's always me, number one. He's looking at me. You lower your gaze. Don't look at him, says, you lower your gaze. You lower your gaze. And show him by action, you're the Muslim woman. وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. They remember Allah a lot. Where is your dhikr? 2 minutes after salah, we couldn't sit. 2 minutes. And you tell me you want to be the best, and I need to go to the masjid? Well, here you are. Alhamdulillah. Masjid is very welcoming. Beautiful. Beautiful woman. Education. Room. Where are you? Don't blame anyone. As the shaitan said, this is one of the powerful verses in the Quran, Surah Ibrahim. لما قضي الأمر قال الشيطان. The meaning of it, لا تلوموا أنفسكم. لا تلوموني ولوموا أنفسكم. Don't blame me. Shaitan is going to talk on the day of judgment. He's going to look at you and me. He says, don't blame me. Blame yourself. ما كان لي عليكم من سلطان. I had no power over you. إلا except دعوتكم. I called you. فاستجبتم لي. You answered. Don't pray, there's still time. You said yes. Let's keep looking at the social media with all the haram. You said yes. Right? Don't put your hijab. You said yes. Let's do this. You said yes. ما لي عليكم من سلطان. I had no control over you. إلا أن دعوتكم فاستجبتم لي. I called you. You answered. فلا تلوموني. Don't blame me. Blame yourself. ما أنا بمصرخكم. I will not come to your rescue. وما أنتم بمصرخي. And you will not help me. Do you want to be that person? Can I afford it? Do I have an answer? Let me give you, and I will end up with this, some examples. And you just look at yourself. And there's a book called Sifatul Safwa, a special of the special. And there is a whole volume about men and a volume about women. And the volume about women, half of it have no names. And some of the men's side has no names. They call it Abida. Abida, you know what? A she worshiper. So let's look at some of them. Some of them has names and some are not. And this is a woman said the following. And see, where are we? She said, I am so surprised. This is a woman. I'm so surprised that an eye can sleep and knows there is a long sleep waiting for her. What make you say this? What make you say this? This is not something comes you read. This is not something you think of. This is something you feel and you ponder and you live, that you cannot but think this way. This is a woman. Her focus is Akhirah, Jannah. I'm going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm going to be there. قال كم لبثتم في الأرض عدد سنين. Allah said this in Surah Al-Mu'minun. How long you lived in this life? We're going to be asked. And we're going to say, قالوا لبثنا يوما أو بعض يوم. فاسأل العادين. And we will say, Ya Allah, we lived a day or two. Ask those who are counting. قال إن لبثتم إلا قليلا. لو كنتم تعلمون. You stayed little with the time, but you didn't know. Focus. You want to be the best. You want to worship Allah. You want success in this dunya. You want success in the akhirah. Don't waste your energy about everything else. Focus on Him and Him only. Those of you who were studying with us in the year of knowledge, they have heard this statement from me. Probably, I think now we are 1,000th time. And I always say this, and I say this to myself before anyone. Everything you do, You say, you don't do, you don't say, has to go through this circle. And this circle is Allah. Subhanahu. Is he okay with it? Is he happy with it? Then go. If he is not, the answer is no. Even if this whole world will say yes, then you are the best. Then you are Sayyida Aisha. Then when Allah tests you, you will respond, Allahul Musta'an ala ma tasifun, and Allah will help me. And when you talk about Sayyida Maryam, and I was listening to it, beautifully said, you know what came to my mind? Why did Allah choose her? The verse that was shared with you was in Ali Imran. But if you read the page before, if you read the page before Allah said, Ya Maryam, inna Allah astafaki wa taharaki wa astafaki ala nisa'i al-alameen. Before Allah told her, Maryam, you're chosen. What did he say? The page before. كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقا. Every time Sayyidina Zakaria enter where? Watching TV, on her WhatsApp, talking with her friends, shopping. It's not funny, it's painful. You know why? Because I want to be like Sayyida Maryam, but I want the end. I don't want to go through the path. I want to be like Sayyida Aisha. And I think it's the other people problem. It's the other people putting me this. No, I don't want to go through that path. I want the quick result. I don't want to get up at 3 o'clock in the morning and stand on my feet and do 2 hours of qiyam. So Allah looks at me and says, "Stafaytuki, I chose you." La, but I can do 3 hours on the internet, chatting, going through. So the best is the examples you heard all day today. But the question has to be, what do I need to do in this day and age to be them, to get that result? And I will end up with this. And I remind myself of this verse almost daily, if not more. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُولَنَا وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمَعَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Those who struggle, look at the word, jihad. Allah used jihad. It's not about fighting. There's no war here. Jihad, struggle, fina, for Allah. لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُولَنَا. He will take you, guide you. Don't worry. وَاللَّهِ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّهُ. And I said by his name, if I was a Sayyida Maryam, and you are Sayyida Aisha, wallahi al-masajid will be open to us. We will have our beautiful places. You know why? Because he will make it happen. But he wants to see it me first. I want it, and I'm ready to work for it, and I'm ready to give up things for him. You do that and see the wonders Allah will show you. But you want to be in your comfort zone, and you don't want to be different, as beautifully you heard. What difference is mean? I lived it also. When you are the only woman, the only, and I'm sure you lived it too. The only woman in that room looks this way. The only woman in that room doesn't speak this way. The only woman in that room. And I kept on saying, طوبَى لِلْغُرَبَى. You know what I just said? جَاءَ الْإِسْلَامُ غَرِيبًا وَسَيَعُودُ غَرِيبًا. Islam came as a stranger and will come back as a stranger. Look around you. Aren't we strangers? And what did he say to you and me and every stranger? طُوبَى لِلْغُرَبَى. It's a place in Jannah. Don't you want to be that person? Why do you worry? Why do you waste your energy? اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب رب ارحمني رشدي وقني شر نفسي يا الله يا الله يا كريم يا حي يا قيوم أنت ترى مكاننا you see our place وتسمع كلامنا and you hear our voices and what we are saying يا الله أرنا الحق حقا show us truth as truth and show and help us to follow it. Show us falsehood as falsehood and help us to stay away from it. إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعاء. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه تسليما.